essentially what's happening is he got caught with books, and now he has to burn the books himself, and that was his job, was to burn books. Montag, can't you run? Get away. No, cried Montag helplessly. The hound. Because of the hound. They were hurt and beating. I think he was meant for him. Hurt. Yes, the hound somewhere about the neighborhood. So don't try anything. Ready? Ready. Montag snapped the safety catch on the flame thrower. Fire. A great nuzzling gout of fire leapt up at the book. Showed that he had lived here, and this empty house was a strange woman who would forget of him tomorrow. He had gone and quite forgot him already. Listening to his seashell radio bore in on her and in on her as he rode across town alone, and as before, it was good to burn. He felt himself gush out in the fire, snatch, rent, rip in half with flame, and put away the senseless problem. If there was no solution, well then now there was no problem either. Fire was best for everything. The books and Montag. The books leapt and danced like roasted birds, their wings ablaze with red and yellow feathers. And then he came to the parlor, where the great idiot monsters lay asleep with their white thoughts and their snowy dreams, and he shot a bolt at each of the three blank walls, and the vacuum hissed out at him. Emptiness made an even emptier whistle, a senseless scream. He tried to think about the vacuum upon which the nothingness had performed, but he could not. The odorous breaths of the vacuum could not get into his lungs. He cut off its terrible emptiness, drew back, and gave the entire room a gift of one huge bright yellow flower of burning. The fireproof plastic sheath on everything was cut wide, and the house began to shudder with flame. "When you're quite finished," said Beatty behind him, "you're under arrest." The house fell in red coals and black ash. It bedded itself down in sheepy pink and gray cinders, and smoke plume blew over, rising and waving slowly back and forth in the sky. It was 3:30 in the morning. The crowd drew back into the house. Struck him with a blow on the head that sent him really back. The green sidewalk, a beauty snatched up, grinning. He held it half in, half out of his ear. Montek heard this distant voice calling, Montek.